Boom. Yo. Gah. The thing goes grrrr. Skinny kid pop pop. And the poop poop grrrr. Boom. Skia.
What's up, y'all? Y'all know who it is, man. Mr. Two New Hairdo. Lethal, man. And we back up in this thing with another reaction video, man. Ooh, it feel good to be back. But, man, as y'all can see up on the screen, bro, I thought it'd be dope and a good-ass reaction to react to Uncle Ruckus.
What did he say? Hey.
Uncle Ruckus origin story. I'm probably the only dude in the world, baby, the black dude that ain't seen this, bro. So, man, hopefully y'all enjoy it. If y'all do, drop a like on this thing right now, bro, for the laughter that we gonna share together. Subscribe to your boy, and let's get into the video, man. Let's go.
My name is Uncle Ruckus, and this is the story of my relations. I was born under unusual circumstances. It was the 4th of July, and I was told it was an especially good night to be born.
All right.
That was some bullshit.
I came as soon as I heard. What is it, Doc?
There's no easy way to put this. That brown spot on your child's arm. It's a rare and incurable skin disease. It will spread all over his body. His skin will continue to grow blacker and blacker and blacker and even blacker and more blacker and blacker.
Blacker and blacker and blacker and even more blacker. Oh, shit.
Vegetable from a Negro.
No!
Not that. Anything but that!
No! Hey, you! What are you doing there? Hey!
Hey, Juju, tell Mom I'll be right back.
Oh, dang.
Who left this motherfucking baby on my steps?
Sweet Jesus.
I'll cut this motherfucker.
No. Right. This ain't no regular baby. It's a white baby. It's the most beautiful white baby in the whole wide world.
White baby? Oh, shit. That's all I need. A goddamn white baby kidnapping charge. Bitch, put that thing down before the police come. No.
Not the fact that he said that last thing I need. Goddamn white baby kidnapping charge. A white baby kidnapping charge. Come on, man. You don't want that.
No, wait. Here's some money. Somebody wanted us to take him.
Shit. Finding white babies might be better than I thought.
What's this? Some kind of birthmark?
It don't look like no birthmark I ever seen.
Who knows? I'm sure it's nothing, mister. Can we keep him? Can we love him forever and raise him to be our own beautiful white child? As husband and wife?
Fine, bitch.
Oh, thank you, mister. What should we name him?
We gonna name it after my uncle.
Okay, Uncle Ruckus it is.
But if the authorities come, you go in jail, bitch. I didn't know nothing about this white baby shit.
The revitiligo spread rapidly across my whole body. Like that black symbiote that turned Topher Grace into Venom in Spider-Man Part 3. By the time I was 3 years old, I was indistinguishable from any other African Negro child.
Uncle! Uncle!
I'm coming, mister!
My adopted Negro father was a loser, even by loser Negro standards.
Yes, mister?
Why you frolicking in the damn field? Frolic your ass to the store and get me some beer, nigga.
He was miserable, that's for the sake of being miserable. But what I remember most was his unwarranted hatred of the white man.
Goddamn crackers. Black man can't get ahead for nothing.
I remember him making me feel very ashamed for my very own whiteness.
I hate all these white motherfuckers.
But Mom, I'm white.
Daddy's just upset, baby, because he's like... lazy, and the white man makes him work hard.
I had two younger brothers, my brother Darryl and my other brother Darrell. But Mr.
Darryl
always
and
seemed
Darrell.
To send me out the way. I would get beatings for anything.
Nigga, did you just break that vase?
having fun with off limits in Mister's house.
Nigga, did I just catch you having fun?
Not the fact he said, nigga, did I just catch you having fun? Come on, bro. Come on, though, dog.
Sweet Jesus, Lord have mercy, my baby.
Every day, he reminded me of what a failure I was going to be.
Mister, I want to be a doctor when I grow up.
Nigga, did I just catch you wanting to be shit?
Sweet Jesus, Lord have mercy, my baby.
My darling, I can't do this, bro. Negro mother, who I loved almost like she was white, did the best she could.
Now, don't you listen to him, Uncle. You ain't no worthless nigga.
Uncle?
Deep down in your heart, you always have to believe that you are special.
She made sure I knew all my white history.
Mama, who is George Washington Carver?
He's the man responsible for more peanut allergy deaths than anyone who ever lived. Baby, why don't we read about Eli Whitney instead? He invented the cotton gin. He was a great white man, just like you.
Many a night,
I just can't do this.
I dreamed about my biological father returning to take me away to white people land, but it never happened. When I thought it couldn't get no worse, my grandmama showed up at the doorstep.
I'm dying.
She was the only person I ever met more miserable than my daddy.
Ugh, look at you. Didn't I tell you you wasn't gonna be shit with your stupid, ugly wife and your stupid, ugly children? I can't wait to die so I don't have to look at your ugly black nigga ass no more. God damn it!
I can't tell you no more!
It was very shortly after that my adopted father threw me out of the house. I ain't seen none of them since. I'll never forget the day my grandmama, Nellie Ruckus, showed up at my house after all them many years. I'll never forget it, because it was a day that scarred me for the rest of my natural bone life.
Ah! Ow! God damn it! Oh, Uncle, it's you.
Nellie? Nellie, is that you?
Nigga, I thought you was a burglar. A big, fat, funky, nasty, stinky, black, one-eyed motherfucking burglar.
What are you doing here?
Uncle, I'm dying. Doctor says it's gonna be any day now, and I just couldn't do it. I couldn't die in your father's house.
I haven't seen or heard from you since the day Daddy threw me out 53 years ago.
Yeah, so? What's new with you? Your daddy always used to say you wouldn't amount to shit. Do you even have a job?
I have 47 jobs, actually.
Yeah, right. Is one of those jobs that Unabomber? And how am I supposed to die in this fucked up chair? No lumbar support? You want me to die with back problems? You raggedy motherfucker.
Your story is just so powerful.
How she gonna come
so
to somebody's
sad.
House?
Real, real.
How she gonna come to somebody's house and complain about they chair? Where she gonna be? And wasn't she supposed to be dying 56 years ago? Why you ain't dead yet? Why you ain't in that dream? Why you ain't 6 feet under yet?
I mean, I ain't gonna cry because that's gay, but it is real sad.
But I don't know what to do. I swear I can't go back home with that woman there. Please don't make me go.
Oh, I get it. You leave me in the shack, and you come and hang out in here in the fancy motherfucking mansion. Get out of my way, goddammit.
I get out of here, Rob. I get out of here.
This? Oh, shit. Now, this is a dying chair right here.
No. That's my chair. That's a living chair.
Oh, yeah.
Said that's a living
I'm
chair.
I'm gonna get buried in this motherfucker right here.
Grandma Nelly, please. You can't die in Robert's chair. Let's go back home.
I don't want to die in that shithole. I want to die in the fancy fucking mansion. I only get to do this once, and I'm gonna do it right.
Daddy? Daddy is coming here?
I told him I was here, and he told me he want to come watch me die. Ain't that a bitch?
Good, he can take your ass out of here and watch you die someplace else. Never that bitch trying to put a blade on me in my house.
It was the first time seeing my adopted family in 50 years. My mother, Bunny Ruckus. My brother, Daryl. And my other brother, Darrell.
Darrell.
Finally, my father, Mr. Ruckus.
Is the bitch dead yet?
Can you dig how nice it is to see all of my boys under one roof? Oh, my God, he's good, ain't he? We got so much catching up to do. Now, Uncle, did you know that Daryl is an accountant for a white finance company and just got a promotion from his white boss? Ooh, isn't that amazing?
That's wonderful, Daryl. A white man promoted. Congratulations.
Oh, it's really not that big a deal.
And Darrell here owns his very own motorcycle shop, and he's married to a white woman. woman. Oh, she's the most beautifulest white woman you've ever seen. And she has his name tattooed right here on her white titty.
Mama, that's personal.
I can't believe it. My own brother with his name tattooed across a white woman's milk gland. Congratulations.
I'm big enough accomplishments. What'd you accomplish, boy?
Hush, mister. I'm proud of Uncle. He lives in this beautiful neighborhood around some lovely white people.
He live in a shack on the outskirts of town.
He works hard.
And still ain't got shit. And ain't never gonna have shit. You know what that makes you? A Mexican. Is that what you've accomplished with your life, boy? Being a Mexican? You ain't even gotta speak English to be a Mexican. Whose fault is it that you a professional Mexican? Is that my fault?
He's not a Mexican. Bro, he's our
this son. Is crazy,
you
bro.
Always treated me different. You never loved me because I am adopted.
Adopted? Boy, you still believe that shit? God damn it, how old are you?
Mister, stop.
You still believe you got, what was that called? What'd you call it, re-vitiligo?
Daddy, come on.
Re-vitiligo.
He does have re-vitiligo.
You ever heard of anybody else having re-vitiligo? Your mama made that shit up, boy. She thought it'd be good for your self-esteem if you believed deep down you was white. That's why they shouldn't let dumb bitches read psychology books.
That's not true. We found you on the doorstep. I
don't
swear.
Hate you because you adopted. I hate you because knocking up your mama killed my chance of me ever experiencing a single moment of happiness or joy for the rest of my damn life.
Baby, don't listen to him.
After that, it was more and more hungry niggas' mouths to feed. All my big plans gone right down the shitter. I worked my life away for these damn crackers. Still couldn't make my ends meet.
Mister, now you leave the white man out of this.
Shut your ass up, bunny. I'm sick of you talking about that goddamn white man all the time. Name one of them who ever did shit for any of you. Huh? Can't do it, can you? Look at what you did. All my kids is some damn Uncle Toms. And you the worst. A black fool who hates himself so much he can't even see what's in front of him in the mirror. Just another black nigga like the rest of us.
I hate you. You're the reason why after I say the name Ruckus, I always say no relation. I am adopted. I am adopted.
It's a shame. He looked like all of them. Get together more often.
He looked like all his brothers.
Uncle, she gone.
In my living room? Oh, no! In my living chair? Oh, no! Huey, get my chainsaw.
Where we going?
Back to the hotel, Daddy.
Already? Let's keep partying. She's finally dead.
It's not true, is it? What Mister said?
You know you can't listen to that black fool. Your dad is just miserable because he never learned to love the white man. Mark my words, he's gonna end up just like his mama. Just be happy you're adopted, son. We darkies are a mess.
Buddy, get the molasses out your ass and come on.
The family decided it was best to bury Nellie Ruckus here in Woodcrest. That was on account of the generous 70% discount offered to employees, such as myself.
Mind if we help? Don't seem like this should be all on you. Oh, that's a fit.
That's a good one, Daryl. Good one too, Darrell.
You did Darrell. Always seem
Darrell and Darrell, I swear to God.
But I never could understand.
Black parents do do that, though.
To be so hateful, so mad at the world, for no reason.
Look, nothing excuses what Mister did to us growing up. But as we got older, we saw things. The white folks Mr. worked for, well, they didn't always treat him very well.
Now, that's crazy talk.
No, Uncle, it's true. Every time Mr. went out into the war, the white man took a little more of his dignity, and his sanity, and his humanity. He served white folks his whole life. He even worked for the police department as a practice dummy.
Sometimes they would just abuse him for no reason.
Good job, boy. Yeah.
Hide.
Well, he must have done something. It just ain't in the white man's nature to act cruel for no reason.
Sometimes I think him being so hard on us was his misguided way to try and toughen us up for a tough world.
Nellie had a statement that she wanted read today. For the last 6 decades of my miserable life, I had only 2 wishes.
The first was to die. The second was that my only son, Mister, would somehow reach the grave before me. While I am obviously disappointed that this didn't happen, and I curse him from the grave, I'm still pretty happy to be dead.
That was beautiful. Thank you. However, I get the last word because I'm alive, bitch. And a round of applause for my son, Uncle, for the fine job he did digging the grave. It's okay, boy. I had some shitty jobs in my day. Of course, that was back in Jim Crow. Now, how you gonna be a failure in the 21st century with a nigga in the White House is beyond me.
Dad, that's enough.
Dad, please. No, that's okay. Keep talking, Daddy. That's the eulogy this old woman deserves. Oh, she did this to you, and now you doing it to me. You've been doing it our whole lives, and it's getting old. It's getting real old, man. So get it out your system, then sit down and shut the fuck up.
Shit. Boy, what did you say to me?
What part in particular?
I'll show you what part in particular.
And man, we gonna end it right there though, man. If y'all enjoyed what y'all seen, drop a like on this thing right now though, bro. Subscribe to your boy, and let me know down in the comments if y'all want to see more reactions up on the channel, bro. And we are out of here, bro. Uncle Ruckus probably got the silliest goddamn back origin story, and it's kind of sad, but man, we out of here, bro. Yeah.